Hi everybody, welcome to this first lecture of Houdini. And in this lecture we're going to build a very small project, which is going to be a procedural stair. And with this small project we're gonna go over all the paradigms in Houdini on a very basic level, so that you have a little bit of an idea what you can expect from this program, and that you might get a little bit an idea what the structure is of this whole thing. This is going to help you in the future to understand more complex projects, etc. So to give you an overview a little bit, we have over here the 3D viewport. To turn it around, you can press the space bar, and it's actually the same controls like you have in Maya. But in Maya you have to press the Alt button to do all kinds of operations with the left, right and middle mouse button. Over here you do it with the space bar. Then we have over here the tree view. This is just a little bit of default layout of Houdini, and in this tree view you see all kinds of different paradigms. Now we're going to go deeper in this later, but basically if I go roughly over them, channels, these are operators on curves. You could compare it best with that, all kinds of curve operators and curve animation curves mainly. You can do very very interesting things with this, but yeah, that's the main issue. Images, this is a compositing part, so over here you can take in images, you can do all kinds of compositing operators onto them and render them to a final result. Then we have OBG. OBG, this is in fact the scene, as you can see with this clapboard. This is where you place the cameras, where you place the lights, etc. Now within this OBG, within the scene format, you can create also objects. So I will create one now. Probably you have the screens switched around. Probably you have it over here. And as you can see, we can turn or switch these things up and down over here. I'm gonna talk to you about the interface a little bit later on. But right here in the OBJ, by pressing tab or by looking what you have over here, both of these things are the same, you can add nodes. So let's add a node, and I'm going to add geometry. So I do this by left mouse button clicking and just dragging it over here within the node view. And like that you see suddenly a node appearing with geometry. Now if you see over here, you see suddenly something has happened to the scene, and a geo node has been added. So this gives you a new paradigm, and the geo is for creating the geometry itself, so it's the modeling part. Now to continue over here, we have right here the output. This you can use to render out images, but you can also render out all kinds of things. You can render out geometry as well. You can render out audio, I believe, but I'm not sure for that. Anyways, this allows you to create all kinds of output systems. You can also have point capture files being outputted over here. Then right here, particles. This is for the dynamics. You can use this for creating particle effects or for objects with collision, etc. Shop is the shader network, shader operators. So this is where you create all kinds of shaders, meaning how the surface of the object would look like. Now this is a little bit different than in Maya. It's also working with nodes, but you go much deeper into detail, so you have much more control over each one of the operators over here. And then VEX. VEX is in fact the node-based language. It's some kind of a MEL node-based version thing. And you use VEX to create, for example, the shaders over here. But you can use VEX not only for shaders, you can use it basically for all kinds of paradigms over here. So it's very powerful. Now the cool thing about this, about all these things, is they are not separate entities. In Houdini, you can communicate between each one of those. You can have connections of values and expressions between everything over here. So this gives you a very, very powerful operator tool. So this is just a very quick explanation of all this, and you can use this whole thing to navigate, to go from one part to another, as you can see over here, in which we change. Right, so I explained over here how you can add some of the objects. Over here you can see there are much more things. You have, for example, auto-rigging tools. Now, at the moment I am still not that fond about the rigging in Houdini. First of all, it's much slower than in Maya, and it's quite hard to set up properly, so I tend to neglect these. So, but you have all kinds of operators over here, muscle systems, dynamics for geometry, all kinds of managers. Yeah, we go into those things later on. But now the first thing that we're going to do is we're gonna start up with the stair system, and that's for the second part.